like lately you're go crazy.
So we just moved in and he's totally shocked by, I think, a lot of things.
A lot of things.
Right. So first of all, let me just say we love living here. We're so excited. And I had some culture shock when I first came here as a student, but I'm pretty used to it. So, and a lot of the culture here is similar to my parents' island culture in the Caribbean, so I'm pretty okay.
Yeah, there are a whole list of things that I got shocked here. First is like the nature, really stunning. I was really shocked how beautiful the island is. The next thing is, and there are a lot of other people half naked and just sit outside on the street hanging out. Since Korea is really considered culture, it's kind of shocking to see people outside half naked sitting around and just drinking and hanging out.
Yeah, there are people like that, so he just means like no shirt. But sometimes his version of half naked is like, took this picture here and he sent it home and his parents are freaking out. Because they're asking him why he's naked outside.
And so that's the culture that I took. I think it's very convenient, very comfortable. Now I can just kind of walk me around shirtless. I think it's fine, right? I hope it's fine. And also, I have spotted a couple people just exercising on the street. They were jogging, and then they suddenly stopped running on the street, and they started like doing push-ups, sit-ups randomly on the street. That's really shocking because, again, Korea. I mean, that's really strange for us to see, but I think it's kind of cool.
That's one thing I like about moving here is that in Korea, I can't really work out leisurely.
People
in the
will
streets.
Look at you.
People act like
crazy. I don't know. Yeah.
So it's uncomfortable. I really miss outdoor workouts while I was in Korea.
The next thing is, I also learned that there are a lot of locals here enjoy hanging out at night by the ocean. Sounds a little crazy to like Korean here because night is dangerous. Maybe it's also because I'm from a city where there's a lot of crimes. But it's kind of shocking to see people want to hang out in the darkness by the ocean. In Korea, ocean is dangerous. Like at night, anything can happen.
But first of all, his neighbor is not dangerous. I don't know what he's talking about. Korea is so freaking safe. It's so safe.
Compared to New York?
Yeah, I'm from New York. It's so freaking safe. I don't know what he's talking about. Safety is one of the prime things I like to believe in Korea. I think he thinks everything is dangerous too. I don't know what he's talking about. I had a blast hanging out with my friends on the beach at night, drinking a beer, looking at the ocean, talking, chilling, barbecue, bonfire parties. I had a blast in college here doing that.
I think I have experienced that. So it's really cool to see after 4 or 5 p.m. I kind of noticed the locals are out on the street and running and exercising.
It wasn't like that before though. It's a new change. It's really nice to see everybody out. They're either doing water sports or they're doing some kind of like physical activity.
It feels like the whole village are like exercising after like 4.
Not everybody, but...
Maybe not, right? I see chickens walking around people everywhere, mm-hmm. especially in the countryside. There are so many chickens everywhere. And I was telling her, because Koreans love fried chicken, if more Koreans come here, they'll be like, jackpot!
Some chicken would be safe.
I also noticed here, guys are shirtless and girls are wearing bikinis, which is rare to see in Korea. I remember I ran in Korea before shirtless and everyone was shocked, and I got shocked later because everyone was shocked. It's good to see Bia in bikinis anyways.
Whenever I went swimming with a Korean group, I was always the only person in bikini. Everybody else, okay. Like, I'll look for a picture, like, head to toe covered. They have the glasses, they have the hat covering their whole face. They look like...
And
like,
sunglasses, yeah. You know, with the handkerchief?
Yeah. Some of them have a scarf around their neck to cover here. Yeah. And then, like, there's a rash guard covering, like, their wrist. Ankle, everything is kind of on pants, they have on shorts. Oh, here I am with a freaking bikini on. Yeah. But I just stopped caring after a while. It is nice now, I can just wear a sports bra and leggings. Oh my gosh. And go outside and just run because Guam is hot.
Yeah, it's
Guam is
hot.
Really hot.
Next thing is rain. It rains randomly and stops randomly too. Next thing, So parking lot, I noticed parking lot is kind of like hangout space for many people here. Somehow I've seen a lot of people hanging out in a group, in the truck, or in a car, or halfway in a car at the parking lot. I just don't understand because we don't have that culture.
Right. So one of the fun things to do here is just cruise around and just chill out in different places, different beaches, different areas. When I went to school here, the fun of nightlife wasn't going to the club or the bar or something. I mean, they have it here, but the most fun I had here was literally chilling out in the parking lot with beach chairs and like a cooler and some drinks and playing the music from the car, or if someone had a pickup truck, just sitting in the truck and chilling. Like that to me was one of the most, like, that was the most fun. I don't know, but.
Next thing, I personally haven't really experienced this. I need to make more local friends, but I was told that people here in Guam are all from different islands and they are kind of divided by these islands. Korea also has that kind of thing. People find it more close when they see another person come from the same region.
There's a huge Filipino community here. There are some East Asians. So one thing that we should point out is that Guam is America. It's in a territory. So a lot of people don't know that. A lot of people said, oh, I thought you were moving to America. I said, this is America, guys. A lot of my friends back home are like, where is Guam? The native people here are called Chamorro, and they have other people from FSM, the Federal States of Micronesia. And they're just in other smaller islands. There's Ponape, there's Yap, Chuuk, Palau, Marshall Islands. I've met a few like Samoans and other smaller islands. Other than that, there are like military living here. So there are a lot of different kinds of people and different groups and social structure, basically just like any other place.
I cannot wait for us to go around all these islands
right
there.
Ah, Saipan too, there's Saipan.
Yeah, it'd be awesome. Mm-hmm. Oh, and next thing is, it's kind of shocking and kind of cool too, this military presence in the island. And I hear fighter jets flying every day almost. And I saw bomber, like really like kind of cool shaped airplanes and big with a big radar and like a lot of stuff, a lot of military stuff is here.
It's like a little bit scary. Sometimes we're here just barbecuing outside and then everything will start shaking.
Oh yeah.
And then the wind is blowing and we see like freaking jets going over our heads.
Yeah, it's
really
so loud.
Close. It's so loud and cold. Like, but everyone here is so used to that.
Yeah.
Should we be used to this? Is this okay that this is normal?
Next thing is, my sounds very strange, but I was shocked to see people in the water. So when you go to Korean beaches, did I pronounce it right? Beaches. Somehow Koreans don't want to get tan and they don't want to get wet. So even though they're on the ocean, they don't go into the water.
They never go in the water.
Like most of them. It sounds weird, but it's actually shocking to see everyone is in the water here, including me.
So there are Koreans here, but the Koreans don't actually go in the water. They stand outside and they take pictures. Koreans don't like to be in the sun either, so they're not like tanning, lying around.
Definitely.
In Korea, under the umbrella, eating ramen and stuff. I remember we went with a group before and I was lying in the sun and fell asleep after. I love sleeping on the beach, and all the Koreans were shocked and they kept waking me up telling me like, hey, you have to wake up, you can't do this. Yeah, I'm like, yo, it's too late. I'm so round. I woke up, they put an umbrella over me anyways.
Oh.
Like, yeah. And there's floaties everywhere, so no one's really swimming.
Next thing is, a lot of strangers who have encountered randomly say nice things. Like, oh, hi, like, how are you guys? We're always good to see you guys today, or something like that. Which is shockingly nice to see, because Koreans, we usually don't talk to strangers. It's weird. And it's somehow even rude to talk to strangers, even though it's just like saying hi. It's just strange for us. But it's really nice to see people like say hi, even though they don't know me, I don't know them.
He got so shocked because people here are really friendly, so they'll just come up to you and hi. Just if you make eye contact or something, or you know, people, hey, you know, like have a good day. Just they're just really randomly nice. It's really comfortable. People ask, how are you doing? And the first time it happened, he freaked out. He's like, what should I say? And I'm like,
yeah,
how
I asked
you doing?
A lot of times that, like, oh, in a situation like this person said hi, or like say these things, what can I say back?
Hi.
What's the courtesy? But it's something new for me. But I think it's really sweet.
And here, hi is half a day, so they say half a day a lot. And you can just say it back. People are just really warm here and open, and it's really shocked by that.
Yeah, my next goal is stay half a day back. Yes.
Yeah. We need a jumper cable for our car because the battery died. And I purposely sent him over to a car and said, babe, can you go over there and ask them to, like, if they can, like, give us a jump? And he was hesitating. I was like, just ask. And I just want to push him to talk to people and, like, you know, just get used to that. I mean, because it's nice. It's like friendly culture. And we need a jump. We got to get out of here. So I saw him freaking out and he ran back. He's like, babe, oh my God. The guy was like scary and like the car was like tinted through windows. I ended up asking the guy to cable. The guy didn't have a jumper cable, but he could still charge our car with his battery. And so the guy came over to tell us that. And he was wearing a pink shirt. He was smiling and stuff when he walked over. And he gave us a jump.
Another thing that Japanese, so many cars are pitch black. Oh, you're thinking?
Yeah, so there's a reason for that.
And it's kind of shocking to see because I never seen this much pitch black windows, which means I don't know what's going on either.
Yeah, also, I remember like the smell of
weed.
He's like, babe, something smells weird. What smells like that? I'm like, hush. And he's like, what's that smell?
Yeah. So I've been wondering why I feel like I kind of stand out here. Because before I come here, I mean, Guam is super close to Korea. It's like 5 hours. So I, in my mind, it's kind of like neighbor country. And also because everyone looks Asian to me, which I am. So I thought they just look like me with like more tan skin because it's an island. And I grew up in city, right? So I thought I'm gonna blend in like locals. You know, I'm Asian, I look like them, they look like me. That's what I thought. But somehow I noticed that I kind of stand out. I also learned a lot of people here are bilingual. Because again, there are so many people from outer islands. So they have their own language from their islands and they speak English. So it's kind of cool to see a lot of people are bilingual. And also, I kind of somehow feel less alien here.
Oh, yeah. So because the U.S. did take over this territory, so not many people speak Chamorro, but each island has their own language, so you are going to hear a lot of different languages here, which is, yeah, pretty cool.
Next thing is, nobody's looking at us weirdly, because we're not so shocking, I guess, compared to Korea, which is nice. So I was shocked to see a lot of Korean churches and Korean marts.
I'm really shocked by how many Korean churches there are. I don't know. It's just weird to me. I went to Korean church before, and after Korean church, everybody has soju and beer, and there is sapje.
Every Korean church,
and everybody got drunk after, and it was great. There was a Korean bowling team. I saw a Korean chess club. It was like, they're just regular stuff, everybody, but there's a Korean everything here. Yeah, like, for separate, Korean stuff is separate.
Lizard. After we moved into this place, the first thing that we found in the oven was baked lizard, which is shocking. I was shocked. Looked like a mirchi, by the way. Mm. Anchovy. Anyway, so there are a lot of lizards. Mom told me tropical islands is kind of common to see lizards everywhere. And even though you heard it before, it's really shocking to see actual lizards like crawling around on the ceiling and on the wall everywhere, right?
Wow, look, it's moving.
It's moving. Wow, it's moving. Okay, it's really cute. It's like finger size. Oh, not like, yeah. But I like it. Really cute. I was pretty shocked, to be honest, in the beginning, but I kind of started to taking a good look, closer look at them. It's actually, it's really cute. Their tiny hands are like so like and I don't know, slimy and maybe sticky, but they're cute.
It's like my mom though. My mom, she was laughing about it. I think your mom was freaking out when she heard about
it. My mom was horrified. My mom was freaking out.
Thanks for watching. We'll keep you updated. Let us know if you have any questions or things you want to know more about. Keep giving us good feedback.
Stay tuned, our international family.